Well, many broadcasts tonight may begin by telling you the name of a murderer who killed 11 people in the synagogue behind me earlier this Saturday morning. They may show you his pictures and repeat his name so much that it'll become as well known as other mass murderers whose names you probably remember. We hope history does not remember this killer's name, and we won't be saying it or showing you his photo in the hour ahead. Instead, we want to take a few moments to focus on those who really matter. On the 11 people who lived good and decent lives, who were loved by family and friends, and who leave behind them broken hearts and happy memories. Daniel Stein was killed on Saturday. He was retired and, according to his son, didn't require much. His son said he was a simple man. His nephew says he had a dry sense of humor. He was deeply loved and will be deeply missed. Daniel Stein, we will remember. Joyce Feinberg was a former researcher at the University of Pittsburgh who treated her PhD students like family, we're told. Her late husband taught at CMU just down the road from Tree of Life. Those who knew her say she had a huge personality that lit up the room. Joyce Feinberg, let us remember. Let us also remember Richard Gottfried. He was 65 and had a dental practice with his wife. He was Jewish, she was Catholic. They counseled other interfaith couples at her church about what to expect. Bernice and Sylvan Simon were married at Tree of Life 62 years ago. Imagine that. Sylvan Simon was a retired accountant. Bernice was a nurse. Neighbors say that she loved classical music and devoted time to charitable work, charitable causes. They were always ready to help, said a neighbor, and always with a big smile. Bernice and Sylvan Simon, they died as they lived together. We will remember them. Jerry Rabinowitz was a longtime area doctor who's being remembered for treating all kinds of patients with kindness and compassion, particularly those with HIV/AIDS at a time when fear of the virus was running high. A patient wrote, "He often held our hands without rubber gloves and always, always hugged us as we left his office." Another called him the sort of doctor who sent you on your way feeling better in all respects. Reports are he was shot as he rushed to help wounded congregants. Jerry Rabinowitz, his patients remember, and so will we. Melvin Wax's sister says that she always used to kid him that he should have been a rabbi. Instead, he was a dedicated congregant attending shul on Fridays and Saturdays. He would always be the first to arrive, she said. Always in a good mood, always full of jokes. Melvin Wax, we will remember. Irving Younger was a greeter with a handshake and a smile he once used as a realtor. He helped people find a seat. A friend says he was the kind of guy who'd walk down the street and say hi to everyone he saw. It served him well at one local cafe where he liked to go. No surprise, perhaps, he made himself the greeter there as well. Irving Younger, we will remember. David and Cecil Rosenthal were called Tree of Life's ambassadors because they were always there. Both had special needs. Both were inseparable. Everyone around here knew them, I'm told. A cantor at a nearby temple calls Cecil the kindest soul you would ever meet. She calls him the embodiment of the community. Another acquaintance says his laugh was infectious, and David, he said, was so kind. The two, he said, looked out for one another, and in return, their community treasured them. David and Cecil Rosenthal, brothers in life and in death, we will remember. And last, but certainly not least in anyone's thoughts tonight, is Rose Malinger. She was 97 years old and lived her whole life in this state. I visited her daughter, Andrea, earlier today. She was wounded and is recovering in the hospital, surrounded by family and friends who smiled and laughed and shed tears when they talked about Rose. Bubby, as she was known in her family. Rose lived for her children and for her grandchildren. She was, they said, a pillar of the community and of the congregation, vibrant, full of life. Moments ago, her family gave CNN this statement. To Bubby, family was everything, they said. She knew her children, grandchildren, and her great-grandchild better than they knew themselves. She retained her sharp wit, humor, and intelligence till the very last day. We will miss her presence and her company greatly. Rose, we will remember. So many people to remember,